Alright, hello everybody, and welcome back to LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga for the DS. Back here again, about to do the Jedi battle and Attack of the Clones, but you guys may have noticed I've gotten a new mic. I'm still kind of working out some settings with it, so it may not be perfect this video, but it's a lot better than my other ones. I don't have to put as many filters on this one as I did my other one, so yeah, but enough of the mic, let's just get into Jedi battle, and let's just keep doing Attack of the Clones. Compared to, well, maybe, I keep making all of these damn comparisons to the console game, and I don't know why. But compared to the console game, the way they did that was just odd. But I need to stop talking about the console game because it's not the console game. And why are his blaster bolts purple? They're not purple. Mace Windu's lightsaber's purple, but not their blaster bolts. But it don't matter. So we have to go save Padme. As Kit Fisto is just standing there. What are you doing, Kit? You're just standing there. Alright. So that's strange. Oh, now he's going. Okay, that was weird. So, let's go over here. To go get those. As that brings her down a little bit. Brings her halfway. Let's kill these droids. Oh. So I just have to do it again. Believe it or not, I don't know if this is how the console game goes, because I didn't play the console version of this level very much, so I'm not real sure. Wait, is there something else I'm supposed to do? I guess so. Okay. Oh. Gotta get another one. Okay, so I can unchain her, whatever. Yep. Okay, so that's good. We get Padme now. So we gotta go get Anakin now. It's always weird how they have set up this mission, even for the console game. It just feels weird, because in the actual movie, they save themselves pretty much, but I guess Mace shoves to go around and save them in the LEGO game. In the LEGO game, not... Don't mind me, I don't know what I'm trying to say. Okay, let's just kill some droids. Enough of me talking. Okay. So I kind of get the premise of this now. So just pull the levers, then kill some droids, go back and pull the levers again, and that's it, I guess. Easy enough, I guess. Alright, so let's go back and go get Anakin. As there are bombs littered all over this mission. Alright, so... Oh, I guess we don't get Obi-Wan yet. Go kill these guys. Come on, there we go. No, I do like the DS game that they kept all of like Mace's special like moves and stuff, like Mace's special jump here, which is pretty cool. Like in the DS game, I know they have to cut a lot of stuff out, but it is cool that they kept all the character-specific, like, cool things that they did in console games. So that's pretty cool. You didn't see that a lot with, like, games that had to be ported over to other the DS at that time. It's pretty cool. I like that. But let's kill this droidica. I have no clue if this is useful for the story or not. It doesn't look like it. Let's pull this lever. This brings everyone down halfway. And we gotta kill some more droids. There we go. I will say, playing as Mace does feel pretty cool. His lightsaber movements are pretty fluid and they feel pretty nice to play as, so. Okay, some Geonosians. Let's go destroy Droidica. Come on. Thank you. Let me kill the Droidica, please. Kill him. Kill him. And then the Droidica. Come on. Okay, so let's go get Obi-Wan. Here he is. Sundo him. And now we have Obi-Wan. I noticed in the DS game, I don't know if they just couldn't render it or not, but they did not get Obi-Wan's hairpiece right on his 3D model, which is kind of annoying, but eh, just what it is, doesn't matter. If you're playing on a normal DS, you can barely tell throughout all the pixels that he is missing his hair, so. Alright. It does not give us a counter to tell how many of these guys we have to kill. It just pretty much implies that we need to be killing them. It doesn't tell us how many we have to kill. Okay, so now we have to fight Jango. I think. Alright, so where is he? Oh, he's over here. Will he be just as easy as he was in the last video? Not sure. Come on. It kind of looks like it is. Oh, I have to chase him around. Okay, so yeah, he is just as easy as he was in the other one. Alright. Okay, that's something I've always hated, and I think it's even in the console game, is that Obi-Wan's holding a green lightsaber and Anakin's holding a blue one. I don't get why they fucked that up, but they did. But, either way, that's level complete. Hey, we do unlock what Mace Windu, though. So we do not get the True Jedi, get some more studs, didn't get any minikit, I didn't even see a minikit. But, let's just continue story to Gunship Cavalry, the worst, if not, well, one of the worst levels. Probably in this game, same as the console game. It's just going to be the same pointless, horrible two-screen thing that the pod race was. All the vehicle missions are like this, but... So I guess the point is to destroy whatever these blue things are. I have no clue what they are, but we have to destroy... I guess as many as we can find, or we have to destroy 8 of them. Oh, here's another one. Oh, hey, minikit. There we go. So where? Okay, where's this thing at? Oh. Is this it? Oh, yep. Those three were at. Alright, so we just go through here. No, no, no. Yeah, please don't do that. Get a survival Lego canister. I don't know what that means. Is that just an extra mini kit that we didn't have to do anything for? Damn it. Oh shit. Okay, that's weird. Damn it, back up. No, this isn't as bad as the console version of this. At least it's a little better. Like, not much better, but it's a little better. Ah, shit. The DS game kept a stupid, pointless fucking timer. I have no clue. Is there a way to turn around? No. Oh, yes, there is a way to turn around. Okay. I knew there had to be a way to turn around somehow. Okay. There we go. As we destroyed that. Oh, do we have to keep doing more? I guess we do. No, 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 stop doing that. Oh, yeah, we do. So in this, we have to do multiple. Which I guess is fine, because this is a lot easier than the console version. Oh, god damn it. Thank you. Back up. Okay, there we go. Alright, so that was a little bit more painless than the console game. This version of that game, both versions of that game, or that level, but yeah, it's still not fun to play, but it was better. I will give them that. But let's just go ahead and finish off Attack of the Clones. Final boss battle of the movie, Count Dooku. Which is actually one of the better boss battles in the game. And it's also one I didn't play very much, so let's just get into it. You know, I will say, the lightsabers in this game, while they are a little bit of a lower quality, they do look pretty good. I do like the way they look. Especially the red ones. Let's get off the droid. Now, let's play as Anakin, because we don't get to play as Anakin with the green lightsaber very often. I'm not mistaken. Oh, we have to wait for Obi-Wan to jump up there. Okay. Shit. God damn it. Okay. Here we go. Oh, so that just, it's for a mini kit. I think we might be able to reach it. Yep. Okay, there we go. Shit. Oh. So we do that by ourselves. Okay. I imagine we have to go through another like little stage like this. Nope, we just go fight Count Dooku, I guess. Okay. So that was like very short. Alright, so let's go do this. which lightsaber combat I hate the worst or hate the most. This game's or this version or the console version. I don't know which one I hate the most about lightsaber combat. Come on, let's throw that back. Okay. Okay, that looked kind of funny, actually. Well. Okay. Alright, so that was actually kind of funny. Oh, here comes Yoda. Got this. This, like, little 2D slideshow, like, little stunts are kind of funny, actually, sometimes. So we're good at jumping all around. Oh, shit. You know what? I like how the lightning works in this one more than the complete saga. The other one, you just had to wait until he shocked you and switched character and then attack. You can just repel lightning in this, which makes more sense because that's what Yoda was doing to Dooku in the actual movie. So, I prefer that over the console game. Okay, so that is level complete. As Yoda grabs the big pillar thing from crushing Anakin and saving the entire galaxy. But saves Anakin anyway, so the rest of this game, so that we have a reason to play the rest of the game. Okay, as we get an image of Yoda shaking his head. I had to turn that into a GIF or something. God, the music, the soundtrack choices for these cutscenes are very questionable at times. Like, there's not a better, like, track you could play for that scene. But, eh, it doesn't matter. Either way. So we get the minikit. Or get a minikit. The gold brick. And that is the end of Attack of the Clones. So yeah, that actually went by pretty quick. Let me switch to everyone. So yeah, that went by pretty quick. Let's go over to Revenge of the Sith. Now, I'm not going to play any of these levels this video, but all of these should be the same battle over Coruscant, General Grievous. Yeah, so they're all the same. I don't... Ruin of the Jedi. Darth Vader. Okay, so, yeah, this is just the same, like, thing. Okay, so there's no Rescue the Chancellor or whatever. Okay, so they took that out. Alright, so I was trying to figure out which one they did take out. I couldn't remember. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. I will probably do a Lego Batman video next, but yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. I will be tweaking on the microphone a little bit. I know it might not be perfect, this video, but yeah, I wanted to do a video with the new mic just to see how it was. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. If you liked this video, please leave a like. For more content like it, please subscribe. Nostalgic 9080 out.